Hi, my name is Kiev Gama. I'm from the Federal University of Pernambuco in the city of Recife, Brazil. I'm presenting the short paper, Participants, Motivations in the Global Service Jam. This is part of the International Conference on Game Jams, Hackathons, and Game Creation Events 2020. The agenda is to quickly present you with some background and related work, the research objectives, the method we followed, the results we gathered, and the conclusions we could draw. The background is around time-bounded collaborative events, such as hackathons, ideations, code fests, and similar events. They're time-bounded because they happen in a short time span, typically a weekend. We're talking about 48 hours, sometimes a little bit more, but typically they last 2 to 3 days. And they're collaborative events because they're done as groups, as joint work. There's also this format of jams. The term is borrowed from the concept used in jazz, where musicians, they get their instruments and their skills, and they play together without rehearsing previously. So they improvise and they create music without any previous definition or any previous preparation. So game jams, they're a similar concept because it's people from different backgrounds, such as developers, musicians, people from sound effects and designers, different background people, they get together to create games in a weekend. Typically, game jams are in a weekend. The most famous game jam is the Global Game Jam, which is the main sponsor of this conference. And there's also this concept of service jams. If you go to globaljam.org, there are different types of jams that this nonprofit organization. They foster these different types of jams. So this article is focused on global service jam. So I'm gonna talk a little bit more about that. So similar to the global game jam, this is an event that happens once a year simultaneously in many cities worldwide. Instead of games, we're talking here about services. So the focus is on service design and prototyping. We're talking about people getting together, people from different backgrounds, marketing, from design, from sales. So they want to do some experimentation, innovation, and work cooperatively in a sort of a friendly competition. This is an interesting aspect. The competition can be fostered by the local organizers if they want to simulate and give prizes to the best prototypes that are created. But the idea here is to have fun. In less than 48 hours, you're gonna develop a prototype of a new service using user-centered design thinking, and different methods that will comprise a process focusing on the user as the main target of the product or service that you're creating. So we're talking about deliverables, which can be a cartoon prototype, a paper prototype, a presentation, or even a concept of an application. So here, the idea is to prototype, not to develop things. And in terms of research, previously, around the topic of participants' motivation in time-bounded collaborative events, we have worked on two previous researches, one about hackathons and the other one about global gap jam. And we found in literature another one that has a focus on the global service jam. So these are some of the related work we wanted to mention ours, because we wanted to continue and understand a little bit more about that aspect in different time-bounded collaborative events. And the other publication from the Global Service Jam 14 in France is that it's quite similar, trying to investigate different motivations of participants. But all of these researchers that focused on survey data only, so no interviews. And we wanted to, besides comparing to work on motivations in these types of events, we wanted to gather more qualitative data, such as interviews, to validate the survey data. So we wanted to study the local edition of the Game Jam, Global Service Jam, in Recife. And then we also wanted to compare results from respondents locally with respondents from other cities worldwide. And then we follow a method, we use a mixed method approach, local and global participants answering a survey with closed and open-ended questions, some liquid format answers, and also some open-ended questions. And the local participants would also be invited to participate in a semi-structured interview. The population was pretty much below what we expected. Among all of the participants, we only got 27 responses. Well, there were 50 to 60 participants locally. We only got 27 responses. And worldwide, we contacted tens of organizers, but we got responses only from 18 participants from 10 different countries. So the majority of the respondents were male respondents. And in the local edition, there were mostly 26 to 35 year old, which was, in terms of the worldwide respondents, not exactly the same proportion. And in terms of interviews, we only got three participants who accepted to be interviewed, two female designers and one male software developer. Among the different motivations that we suggested based on previous literature, this was a very different range of responses, talking about Recife, the local edition of Global Service Jam. We had resolution of problems, learning and think creatively as the top three aspects. The global responses, the worldwide responses, we had learning, fun, and resolution of problems as the most important motivational aspects. And in terms of open-ended questions from all the respondents, local and worldwide, the main lessons learned were about around the collaboration, teamwork, and multidisciplinary teams. They saw it as a complementary background that would improve the solution. Understanding the whole design process or method that was put into practice that was important for a lot of people that didn't have experience with design thinking in practice. This was praised together with learn by doing. So you learn the whole process by applying it at that moment. And they valued the moment of co-design and co-creation among participants of the team and among and together with customers that could be identified. And the difficulties, we could identify some of the top ones. The difficulties to perform teamwork because of the heterogeneity. It's a difficult thing, like people with different background and different perspectives, to find a common opinion, and this was a bit complicated for teams to manage because of the compressed time and of the event. It caused a lot of fatigue, so the short time and fatigue was a recurrent complaint. The loud environment in many places, typically these are open spaces where tens of people working together, so it makes it hard to concentrate. And finding a target audience is quite complicated because you don't necessarily have access to the target audience of the service that you're going to be designing and prototyping. So some people had to call, others went to the streets to find their target audience. And when talking about the interviews, we saw many confirmations of learning as an important aspect. So a lot of people wanted to participate to learn and to recycle, do some networking. Also, they were mentioning curiosity, which we believe is quite related with learning. So they were curious to learn and to understand how things go with service design prototyping. As main lessons learned, they praised the design process, like learning the whole design process in 48 hours, in a weekend. So it was very important and putting that into practice. And as main difficulties, doing teamwork was complicated because this diversity of thoughts made complicated to find a convergence of ideas. So was complicated for many of the participants coping with these differences. And as conclusions that we could draw from these data that we gathered and analyzed is that the motivations to participate as learning and the resolution of problems were in intersection among the local and global service. So learning we found to be a key motivation that was confirmed in the interviews and also in literature. Our previous work on hackathons and global and the global GovGem also involved learning as one of the top three motivational aspects. And there's also literature on global game gen, for instance, talking about learning as an important motivational aspect. And as main lessons learned, the most important one was the importance of the design process according to participants. This this thing that happens in a weekend, they put into practice a whole process from identifying the target audience and their needs to co-creation and to present their product with some validation that typically takes place. And the main difficulty, as I mentioned previously, is a teamwork with people with different backgrounds. Although it was praised as something important in these different backgrounds, it was something that was quite difficult for many teams to cope with, converging these ideas with people with different perspectives on the same topic. And also fatigue and constrained time were very emphasized on the survey answers. So that's basically it. We are happy to be presenting these findings here. And if you're interested in more details, please take a look at the article or send us an email. And thank you very much for your attention.